You've probably heard of the term cyber threat intelligence, or CTI, before. It is constantly cited on social media, makes cybersecurity news daily, and is a top feature on every vendor's newest tool. But what is cyber threat intelligence? What is all the hype about, and how can you actually use it? Let's dive in and demystify the murky world of CTI. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Adam, and I love everything about cyber threat intelligence. I've helped build CTI teams, refine processes, and train clients on the best practices. I've spent years mastering threat intelligence and believe that anybody can benefit from it. In this video, I will take you on a journey to explore what threat intelligence is and how you can use it. You will discover how it can enhance your security operations, streamline your incident response capabilities, hunt for the latest threats, and much more. Before we get ahead of ourselves though, let's start with a basic definition. Cyber threat intelligence, or CTI for short, is a proactive approach to defending an organization against the latest cyber threats. It involves collecting, analyzing, and sharing intelligence about cyber threats and potential risks that an organization might face. A threat is any potential danger or activity that aims to compromise the confidentiality, integrity, or availability of your data. A threat can be an entity, like a malicious insider, ransomware gang or nation state, an attack, like malware, phishing, or DDoS, or even an unintentional action, like accidentally deleting or exposing sensitive information. In CTI, you typically focus on groups, attacks, and vulnerabilities as threats that you want to track and mitigate. Intelligence is collected, processed, and analyzed information about a competitive entity. In cyber threat intelligence, the competitive entity is someone who wants to affect your organization's security, and the information about them provides insights into the threat they represent. So, CTI is just filling knowledge gaps. The primary goal of CTI is to empower operators and key stakeholders to make informed decisions. It empowers operators to make informed decisions when triaging, analyzing, and responding to incidents. This includes security analysts, incident responders, and threat hunters. And it empowers key stakeholders to make informed decisions about what threats to prioritize, what technologies to invest in, and the right strategic decision to follow. Without CTI, organizations would be in silos, each responding to threats in a reactive manner. An organization won't know if an indicator is associated with a particular attack, if this is a new threat actor, or if there is existing mitigation advice to deal with the threat. They won't know what trends are happening across the landscape, and how they might need to realign their strategy to combat emerging threats. So CTI is important for all businesses. The mom and pop shop down the road that needs to know what threats are targeting small businesses, as well as the big Walmart up the road that needs to know what sophisticated threat actors are trying to extort them for money with ransomware. Even defense contractors need to know how to defend against nation states. The stakes are significantly different, but the underlying need to make informed decisions about cybersecurity remain. Not all threat intelligence is the same. Intelligence about real-time attacks and vulnerabilities differs from intelligence about geopolitical events and emerging threats that are exploiting technological trends. Threat intelligence comes in three flavors. You have operational intelligence that focuses on immediate and current risks the security team needs to prioritize in their detection and response efforts. This includes indicators of compromise, malware signatures, and attack patterns. This is used day to day by your frontline teams like security operations and incident response. Next, you have tactical intelligence that focuses on the technical details about specific threats, such as vulnerabilities and exploits. Defenders use this to identify and mitigate particular threats using detection rules and mitigation policies. This intelligence focuses on targeting threat actors' TTPs, or tactics, techniques, and procedures, rather than their individual indicators. Finally, you have strategic intelligence, which provides a high-level overview of the threat landscape to inform broader security strategies, like developing policies and procedures, resource allocation, and prioritizing investments. It includes the motivations, capabilities, and trends, and is used for long-term planning and decision-making. There can be some confusion between operational and tactical intelligence. It is best to think of tactical intelligence as intelligence further up the pyramid of pain, indicators that are more difficult for an attacker to change. This includes specific vulnerabilities, exploit code, and TTPs, rather than atomic indicators like IP addresses, domains, and hashes that are relatively easy to change to evade detection. Building mitigations for indicators derived from tactical intelligence takes longer, but they'll be more robust. Each of these intelligence types is collected, analyzed, and distributed following a model known as the Cyber Threat Intelligence Lifecycle. The CTI lifecycle is a core component of intelligence work and is used to guide the entire process. It consists of six stages that an analyst will follow to collect, analyze, and distribute threat intelligence. Stage one is the planning stage. Here you'll define goals and objectives of your CTI collection, such as your intelligence requirements, what assets you want to prioritize defending, and how you will communicate the intelligence you find. Once you have a plan, you can move on to stage two, collection. This involves going out and collecting threat intelligence relevant to your goals and objectives. This could be open source intelligence, intelligence from proprietary threat vendor feeds, or engaging with information sharing communities. After you collect data, you need to process it. During this stage, you will organize your data into a form that allows it to be analyzed and turned into intelligence. This includes normalizing and structuring data, enriching the data with contextual information, and assessing the credibility and reliability of the intelligence sources where you collected the data from. Next up is the analysis stage, where you'll analyze the processed data for meaningful insights that can be used to defend your organization or inform strategic decision making like strategic intelligence does. Once you've analyzed the data and created an intelligence product, you need to share it. Welcome to the dissemination stage. Here you'll share the intelligence and insights the intelligence provides with relevant stakeholders. This includes tailoring the presentation of the intelligence to suit the recipient so they can effectively use it. Finally, but perhaps most importantly, is the feedback stage. During this stage, you'll collect feedback about the intelligence you shared and the efficiency of your CTI process. This feedback is used to assess the intelligence requirements and make adjustments to align better with business objectives. Operational, tactical, and strategic intelligence all flow through this cycle. The actions performed at each stage vary depending on the intelligence. Some stages are automated, while others require a human analyst. CTI plays a crucial role across various cybersecurity jobs, from deeply technical ones like incident response, to key decision makers like managers or directors. It provides valuable insights into potential threats, vulnerabilities, and risks that help cybersecurity professionals make informed decisions. Say you're working in security operations as a SOC analyst, CTI can be a game changer for you. It can help you efficiently triage incidents by enriching them with contextual information. It can help you proactively defend your organization by supplying information about the latest attacks and vulnerabilities, and it can aid in the development of detection rules and signatures. If you're an incident responder who's putting out the latest fires, CTI can also help you. It can support in the creation and refinement of incident response playbooks that ensure a swift and consistent approach to dealing with cyber incidents. It can help you understand the TTPs an attacker uses so you can direct your investigation efforts. And it can provide you with IOCs for identifying malicious activity on endpoints and networks. But CTI is not just limited to technical roles. It can help key stakeholders make informed decisions that keep their organization safe from the ever-evolving cyber threats out there. CTI can be used by security managers, directors, and executives. It will provide them a comprehensive view of the organization's cybersecurity posture and the threats they face. It will help them facilitate strategic planning for security improvements and investments based on the trends in the cyber landscape. Finally, it can aid in communicating the importance of cybersecurity to key stakeholders by providing real-time data about geopolitical events, security breaches, and trends. CTI can help practically everyone involved in security at your organization, but it can also help those not directly involved in security as well. It can be used to protect your brand, combat fraud, and keep tabs on competitors. If there is a need to fill an information gap to facilitate an informed decision, threat intelligence can help. Cyber threat intelligence, or CTI, is a proactive approach to defending an organization against cyber attacks. It involves collecting, analyzing, and disseminating intelligence about threats an organization will likely face. Technical operators and key stakeholders can use CTI to improve the cybersecurity posture of their organization and make informed strategic decisions. This video is just scratching the surface of CTI, a quick guide to get you up and running. This channel is dedicated to helping you learn everything you need to know about CTI, so make sure you follow along and subscribe. Also, check out these videos on MISP to learn how to collect, analyze, and share threat intelligence using an open source and free platform.